Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the series, If I Produced For. And today we're going to cover If I Produced For Eminem. So it's going to get pretty fun here. Since Eminem has so many styles, it's crazy. I mean, he has pop style, meaning, you know, he has songs where it's just classic guitar and piano. He can get on with a singer. He could do just bass. He could do fast rhythms. He could do goofy rhythms. I mean, the guy mastered rap, and he definitely deserves his place in hip-hop history. But Vanilla Ice, on the other hand, you know, he came and went. We're just playing when we say that. Well, let's open up our sound. So firstly, we're going to open up Keyscape, which has the taxed harpsichord. So this is this like regal type of sound in Britain that you hear a lot, you know, that type of sound. Now, it's giving me a little lag, so it's probably heavy on the processing. So that's going to be annoying. So we're going to probably limit it. Let me just turn up the buffer for a second, just so I can show you what it sounds like. Okay, that type of sound. So, what I've done before the video is recorded. I was just like talking and trying to come up with a concept, because I'm going to show you a cool trick later, which is going to help you in your recordings to rap really fast. Even if you can't pronounce every syllable, I'm going to show you a technique you can use to sound like you're rapping really fast. So let's get out of that. But here's the melody that I happened to come up with.
Pick a pack of peppers, this is Eminem, we stuntin' nigga.
So, dun 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 dun. So I mapped that out on the keyboard, it goes like this. You know. So let's just draw on those notes. Go to piano roll, we're gonna start on A. And I'm using a very low octave. We're at A3, so that's pretty low. Whoops. Let's go back to the pattern mode. So it's all about the harpsichord sound. I mean, there's so many different styles of harpsichord you can find. So, boom, boom. And the technique here is to keep the same bass note, E, but then, you know, increase the note value up top. And then here we're going to use a half step up to create tension. So when we come back to E, it feels more complete. Now this feels a little fast, probably because it's right on the grid. Let's line this up to see if it matches the melody, because it sounds faster than the melody. So here I changed it up. So it goes Eminem. Eminem. I forget the next note. Let me turn up the vocals so you can hear it.
Pick a pack of peppers, this is Eminem. Pick a pack of peppers, this is Eminem.
So here it's changed up from the verse, but we're going to keep my written idea.
Pick a pack of peppers, this is Eminem.
So I'm going to add a half step away, which is going to create tension.
Pick up
Eminem, we stunt. And again, another half step.
Pick a pack of peppers, this is Eminem, we stunt an egg.
So it's okay to use half steps in melody. Now, we're going outside of the scale most of the time when we do that. So that's why it confuses a lot of people. But again, we go over these techniques in Melody Magic. It's a completely new course at BusyWorksBeats.com/Melody Magic. We go over the hidden parameters in melody. Now, another thing about this harpsichord, this is also a combo piano. It's not fully harpsichord. It's also an upright. So let's turn off the upright. So you get the pure tone. Only thing is, I don't like the reverb effects on here. And I also want it to be ding, ding, ding. I want it to be nice short notes. So let's shorten the notes. Now I also want to add a dun, 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 you know, that kind of thing. Dun, 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 dun. So I'm going to add that there. So we're, you know, taking away the coolness of the sound and making it more raw. So I took away the other piano, but when I loaded up the harpsichord sound itself, it sounded a little bit different. This sounds like distorted almost compared to the harpsichords I'm used to hearing. So you can load up harpsichords from Omnisphere as well. So you have a lot of options and different plugins. So that's the core melody. Now what we want to do is thicken it up with some accent. So let's copy the melody. Let's go to pattern two. We're going to open up some spiccato strings. Now I'm going to use a library that's not in the default library. And I think it's Hollywood 3 expansion under strings. We're going to go to Ender Spiccato 8RR 2 Velocity. Now these are like my favorite strings out of all of the Nexus stuff. And I use them in one song called Mysterious. If you go search our beats on YouTube, I have a beat or a song called Mysterious, and I use these strings on that song. It's a very lush string section. Very nice and to the point. Okay, so we're going to use those for emphasis, so let's paste that in and only use it on the downbeats. You know, I don't want to say only or never, but I'm going to use it on the main sections of a song. So let's add this in. Now notice it's a very low octave. Dum. Now with strings, you can play multiple octaves. So let's hit Shift, Control A, hit Shift, highlight, and then hit Control Up to duplicate up an octave. So now it's two octaves. You can even do a three octaves. Let's try it that way. It just adds more impact. Now for the, it's too on the grid, so let's go to the wrench tool, turn up that time shift a bit. Okay, now I'm gonna paste the melody into the swell strings, which we need to load up in Nexus, almost at Omnisphere. And let's see if we can find swell strings in the classical folder so you don't have to worry about the expansions. Let's go to big drama strings. And what I'm going to do is increase the attack. So it takes time for the sound to actually develop. And all I'm going to do here is just delete the extra notes. And whenever there's a key change on the main beats, that's where I'll pay attention to. So let's hit Control A, Alt L will help you drag out the notes so you don't have to like do it manually, but that's what we're doing, just dragging out those notes. I'm going to pull it up two octaves. Let's add this in. And since that's the same note, we can drag that out. Here it goes, dun, dun. Let's change that. Let's make it unique. So it goes, dun, bun. Let's flatten that. Same with the strings. Let's make that second half unique and then flatten the A to an A flat. Other harpsichords have a very stingy type of high end. This one is a little bit different. So I'm just letting you know, there are all types of harpsichords, I guess. Now the last one was going to be trill strings. Let me right click, go to new search, type in trill. And I don't think we have trill stuff in here. So trill string, let's go to contact instead. We're going to load up a library called Session Strings Pro. In there, we can change the articulation to a trill. And a trill is when the pitch goes up and down, it's like vibrato for strings. So it's like, I don't know if I could do it with my voice. Beep. You know, it goes up and down, really quick. That was probably really bad. Let's load up session strings. Haven't loaded them up in a while. Performance mode. And then we want to go to change our articulations. You want to go to the bottom, scroll down in your contact screen, go to articulation, go to main. We're going to change this to trill. And what we can do is just copy what we just what we've done in pattern 4 and 5, or we can combine these. Let's highlight those. Let's go to the playlist options, go to edit, merge pattern clip. So it's just one long clip. So I can just copy this data, go into a new pattern, hit control V to paste. And now we have those same, scroll down, same notes in the, It's a little weird on the, I'm not sure why it sounds, because remember the pitch is going up and down, so it sounds out of key sometimes. So what I like is the A. And I'm not sure about the last note, however. You can accent this a billion times with horns, different orchestra. I'm not going to sit here and bore you with layering. So let's open up some more sounds, like a scratch. Now we're getting into the rhythm. Okay, and we have another scratch. So we can choose between the two. And what is this here? That's the vocal. Save this as new. And let me keep the vocal here just for reference. I was going to delete it. And I think, okay, so now we just need drums. Or we need a bass line too. So let's open up Trillion. Starting to use Trillion more for bass. But you can also use Kontakt. I mean, there's a billion different options. Just pick your favorite plugin for bass. We're going to go in here and let's go to the, where are we at, bass instruments. Let's go to electric fingered bass, and I like the clean Fender, so let's use this. It's a nice clean DI bass, meaning it doesn't have any processing on it. Just to triple check, you can always go to your effects tabs, and I was completely wrong. This has processing on it, so we can turn that off if we want, but I usually like DI bass, meaning it's not processed or there's no effects on it. So as this loads up, we'll let that load. And then what else do we need? Drums. So I'm probably going to load up, what's that drum library that has the snare roll? I think Kontakt library. Yeah. I like the Kontakt library for a specific snare roll that I want to do. Because I've tried Steven Slate, but their snare roll kind of decays. And it's like, it doesn't have the same feel it's going for. So let's open up Studio Drummer. Let's do Stadium Kit. No, let's do Session Kit Lite. Now, somebody's probably thinking that you need a billion and one plugins to do all this stuff. I know it makes it look easier, but remember that these are all creative choices. It's not, you want to get a type of plugin. So these are called sampler plugins. Plugins that sample real instruments and put them into a plugin. So that's what we're going for. It doesn't have to be Kontakt. It could be Sample Tank. It could be, you know, anything. So don't get caught up in the specific thing I'm using unless you really love the sound, because I use a lot of different things. I rarely use Studio Drummer. Okay, so anyway, when I play, I think the note is D sharp because I memorized it. That's not it. Yep, and there's a snare roll. And it's a very specific type of roll, because when you let go of the key, it has a little flam at the end. So I wanted that specific snare roll. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm trying to find out. Hold on. Okay, so I'm gonna start with the snare rhythm, and then we're gonna go back and add sample kicks, because I don't like kicks from these drum kit libraries. None of them. I don't like any of them. I like the drum samples. Remember, when you let go of the key, it adds another snare. So even if you make it this long, it's still going to play another step. So Eminem likes a lot of snares, a lot of movement. Now, I'm only going to use the kick here for reference. So him and 50 Cent and Dr. Dre, a lot of their records have the kick on the snare position. So it goes boom, boom, you know. Let me demonstrate what I'm talking about. So you'll have a doom, doom, doom. And Chicago took that and added it to their drill beats. So they took that from the 50 Cent era and Eminem. It's to put a kick where a snare should be. You can also hear reverb on this kit, which I don't want. I thought I took off the mixer presets, but there's a room mic or a reverb mic. So if you go to the mixer, let's check out the buses. And we don't have any send. Let me see. Is the reverb on? Let's turn this off. Okay, it might just be a room mic. It just sounds like it's probably the room mic that adds that kind of reverb sound. So I'm going to turn off the room mic. I don't want any reverb. Still getting a pretty heavy reverb sound. What we can do, I'm not going to get so specific, but you can actually go to transient shape each sound to cut out any excess. But that's really unnecessary. Let's just do it to the snare since it covers all types of snares. Might as well. Let's turn down the sustain so it doesn't have such a long body. So here's the raw snare. Wow. Sounds really thin. So that's the importance of room mics. I just turned off the overheads and the room mic and it feels like it's like nothing there. So you probably think that was a cheap sample. So it just shows the importance of just having room mics and extra reverb. Even though I don't really like the reverb. Too. So now we have a rhythm, boom, brr-dum, dum, brr-dum, da-boom. So I can get rid of the kicks now. So I'm going to get rid of the swelling strings and leave that for a later section. So let's delete all, whoops, delete all that. I am going to leave the downbeats of the hits, but not the other two hits. We can also add a background organ just to kind of add vibe to it. This is not a requirement. Let's go to vintage organs and contact. And I like loading up the rock organs, classic rock. There's so many variations. I mean, you really want to go through each of these, but I don't want to waste too much time on the sound. If we get a decent enough sound, I would like something with a little more vibrato, but I'm not going to get too caught up in that. So let me copy the merged clip. Let's go to edit, hit control C. Let's go to a new pattern, pattern 9. We're going to paste that into the organ, and that organ just doesn't fill up space. So there's an infinite amount of organs. I don't know if Keyscape comes with organs. This come with organs? I don't believe so. But it's hard to get a really good organ sound. So let's go to vintage organs one more time. And it's all about the presets, so let's just keep scrolling through them. That fills up the background. wish it had a little more cream, a little more body. But let me see if I add an octave. Will that help? So we're going to clone that, add another octave. That sounds a little bit better. Let's add another octave down. Now I think it just needs a little motion. Okay, so we have everything. Let's add the chicka 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 chicka. Very common in Eminem to have those kind of DJ scratches for turnaround, so we're going to add that every four bars. And let's go to our browser. Let's go to busyworksbeats.com. Let's load up the big drums. Where we at? Curtis King. Where you at? Okay. Big drums. And let's load up some kicks and snares. There we go. Okay. Now these have a little, not a little, a lot more impact than those sampler drums from those drum kits. Now again, every four bars or so, I'm gonna add that kind of, the kick is going to be where the snare should be. I'll show you what I mean in a second. Let's add our own snare for more impact, because that snare is very lightweight. Oh, that clap is going to be bomb for the buildup. That is a perfect tone for this track. Okay, so let's go to pattern 13. I'm going to add that in the 2 and the 4 spot, but I'm only going to use it on the second half for more energy, because it's very bright. Let's find a snare that we can use throughout. I like that one too. And we're gonna layer that with something, with a sharper transient. Let's see. I'm gonna turn this down. Just doing something. As the Fecta snare, I always say Fetcha. The Fecta snare is just a New York sound. It's just awesome. So let's use that. Okay, so stuff's loud, so we need to turn stuff down. Now again, the melody, if it's too on the grid, it'll sound too robotic. Some hi-hats. Now the hi-hat either needs to contrast the melody or go with it. So let's right-click, fill each two steps, just to hear what it sounds like with the melody. You know, so tit-tit-tit-tit right on the grid. Let's turn it down first. And let's go to our wrench tool, turn up the time shift. So what I'm going to do is delay the hi-hat. So since we're playing the same rhythm, I'm going to delay it behind the melody. So we, even though it's playing the same rhythm, it has its own space. I wish this had like a loudness to it. It just sounds weak, but whatever. Thank you. Okay, so the Big Drums, Big Drums at busyworksbeats.com/bigdrums. I'll leave a link below. It comes with some 808s, so we might as well stick within the kit here. So let's see what we can add. Okay, pattern 16. Oh, that's right on spot. So right click, go to edit, go to the marker tab, go to detect pitch regions. This one's in the key of A. Let's go to our volume envelope tab, reset your root note, and right click on A. If you mess up, you can just reset it one more time. Now this just happened to match the tone of the song, so I think that's why I liked it. Also, I think, how long is this 808? So it's pretty short, so which is good. I don't want it to be I don't want it to linger longer. So let's go to piano roll. We want to go boom. Now I'm gonna produce it in a higher octave so I can hear the tone. Then we're gonna drop it down an octave or two. Then we're gonna use that half step. Okay, now the only thing I'm gonna change up is I'm gonna dun, dun, dun. So let's go. Bum, bum, bum. So now I'm going to hit control down twice to lower the MIDI down an octave or two. Yo, that was a perfect fit for this song. So let's let the 808s come in a little bit later. Now, just to kind of let it evolve over time, I'm going to open up a grand piano from Nexus and add like a piano section to where we can break it down. And then I'm going to wrap it up and record I want to show you a technique you can do to your vocals to make it sound like you're rapping really fast. So let me see where we at here. But I need to write lyric first before I do it. Let's go to grand piano. Send that to track 17. I'm going to take off the reverb, however, on the sound. I just don't like built-in plug-in reverbs too much. So I'm going to try and play along with the song and just see if I can come up with a chord progression / melody. If not, then I'm not going to spend too much time. So that just was like a freestyle piano session and it worked. So it goes boom, 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 boom. So I'll show you what it looks like in MIDI form. Let's just go to record, notes and automation. I'm holding my sustain pedal. That is how you get the sound. Thank you. looks like. Now, it could be really off because you got to remember I'm recording video and it lags the audio a bit. So let's go to Snap to Grid. I already know most of the notes are going to be early. That's just the nature of the video. So I'm going to move the notes that look offbeat. I'm going to pull them to the right. It's okay that they lag a little bit because it adds groove anyway. Now that's obvious delay, so that's too far back. Let's pull it up. You can see certain notes sound earlier than others. I'm really not going to be a stickler here. Okay, see, instead of going note by note and fixing it, I'm just going to, you know, mass move things. So certain sections are going to sound earlier than others. I'm not going to spend 20 minutes to edit this MIDI. But at least we can grab the group. So at least we can find the culprits. 1, 2, 3, 4. Sorry for the cluster of notes. FL Studio, whenever you play it, it plays all the notes that are there in that section at once. Now when notes overlap in FL Studio, they mute each other, so the E note didn't play just then. And that B got muted, so you gotta make sure when you move notes that they don't overlap. So I said I wasn't gonna spend 20 minutes, I probably am gonna do it anyway. So right here, the note got overlapped somehow. So it worked out. Okay, so that just a little freestyle, you know. But let's add that towards the end of the song so we can fall back on that musicality. Also, we can take out stuff. That's why I created it, so we don't have to have it so heavy. So for example, you could take out your main melody. Actually, now it sounds empty. I was like, where's our bass line? I forgot we had 808s. Okay, so that's our 808. Let's add that in. I want to do something that kind of makes the piano stand out here. Whether it's taking out hi-hats, something has to come out. Out the hi-hat because the rhythmic elements are the melody and the piano together. We don't need hi-hats as a third rhythm because it makes the piano feel like it's offbeat, but it's not. Breakdown section. Now here I want the tuk-tuk-tuk-tuk-tuk to be soloed, so let's figure out where our rhythms are and let's cut it out for that last little bar. So I cut it out too early, which means I cut it too long, so let's get a Snap to Grid beat mode so we don't cut it so long. Am I rhyming? I don't know. it's just, you know, soloed versus with everything around it. Now for the ending, you could take something out like this, maybe the snare bounces. But I'm going to show you another cool technique for when you record vocals. You can make it sound like you're rapping really fast. First step you want to do, I'm trying to decide if I want to. Okay, here's what we're going to do. So if you can't rap to 93 BPM, that's going to be our max BPM, 93. So we want it to sound like we're rapping really fast. So right click, copy the value just in case you forget. And we're going to lower the tempo to something a lot slower. And you're just gonna rap like really slow. Okay, so that's the technique here. Hopefully I have enough time to write a lot of words, because Eminem has a lot of bars, and I mean, that'll take me probably 30 minutes to write some bars, but hopefully I'll have enough to fill up some space. And then I want to show you how to make your vocals sound like they're going faster, and hopefully I come up with a good hook as well. So that will be in part two. I'm going to show you the second half of how to do the technique. Okay, so I kind of went beyond what I expected and I wrote some lyrics. What I would do, this is just a song demo, but what I would do is go back and get a cleaner take, because these takes are uneven in volume, some expressions I discovered later, but you get the gist of the song. So the technique here, what you want to do to make it seem like you're rapping really fast or slow, go to Tools, go to Macros, go to Switch Real-Time Stretching for All Audio Clips, hit Yes. This means whenever you change your tempo, it will change all audio clips to match the tempo, and it will sound as if you recorded it to that tempo. So right now, let me play the verse. It's not fully mixed yet. I'm gonna mix it and give you the final presentation, but listen for the tempo. Then I'm gonna slow it down, and then I'm gonna speed it up.
Married to the rap game, should've got a prenup. I mean, all these corny rappers make me cheese up. I'm mad with the ass with a ski club. All you little rappers on my ass, you can kiss these nuts. Cheap sluts selling ass for like $3. We couldn't even last in the deep, huh? My conversation with labels will make you freeze up. Checks be like the Powerball, nigga, I feel like Freeza. $300,000 an hour, 50 for features. Selling out the stadiums, packed you in the bleachers. Believers, we are the proof for the non-believers. All day I dream about sex, Adidas.
Hi, my name is...
No, hi, I'm famous and my record hella banging while my cash stuff then I came in. With my brothers like the Wayans, slaughtering beats, grab the cane, shoot away at the arraignment. I'm dangerous.
Hi, I'm famous. Hi, I'm famous. Hi, I'm famous. Hi, hi, I'm famous.
Okay, so you can speed up or slow down the tempo. You just have to go to Tools, Macro, go to Switch Real-Time Stretching for All Audio Clips. That means, again, that your audio clips will be matched to the tempo. So it feels like whenever you change your tempo, it will feel as if you recorded inside of that tempo. Whereas before, it wouldn't change the audio length. Okay, so that's the technique. I'm going to go back and mix it and master it just a bit, just so it's presentable. So that's the technique, and it's really fun. So what I wanted to show you how to do, but it kind of got complicated. You want to lower your BPM so that you can rap with the beat. So if you're saying like a lot of syllables, like I contemplated the consonation of alternate, you know, if you're saying something really fast, go to a slow tempo, turn on the metronome, and let's go to something else. So you would go,
I contemplated with constant,
I forgot what I just said.
It's complicated, the consternation is not the nation flipping up the bot to the jacket, Jay, why they stop they hating?
You know, you would say it real slow, then you go back and then do the macro thing and speed up the tempo. So now I'd be like,
the consternation is five places, but that places,
you know, it sound like you were spitting really fast. So it's a really fun technique to use, especially if you have a really cool section where you want to rap fast, but you're just not Twista, or you're not Eminem, or you're not Future. Or designer, I should say. And so that's the technique. I'm not going to keep rambling on, but I'm going to mix it and master a bit just to give you a presentation. And That will be part two. So if you want to learn music theory, which got us through this whole thing, through the melody, it got us through the accompany parts, go to busyworksbeats.com/music theory. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.
Married to the rap game, should've got a prenup. I mean, all these corny rappers make me cheese up. I'm mad with the ass with a ski club. All you little rappers on my A, I say you can kiss these nuts. Cheap sluts selling ass for like $3. We couldn't even last in the deep, huh? My conversation with labels will make you freeze up. Checks be like the Powerball, nigga, I feel like Freezer. $300,000 an hour, 50 for features. Selling out the stadiums packed, you in the bleachers. Believers, we are the proof for the non-believers. All day I dream about Saks, Adidas.
Hi, my name is...
No, hi, I'm famous and my record hella banging. While my cash stuff in a Cayman. With my brothers like the Wayans, slaughtering beats. Grab the K and shoot away at the arraignment. I'm dangerous.
Hi, I'm famous, hi, I'm famous, hi, I'm famous, hi. Hi, I'm famous, hi, I'm famous, hi. And my name is...
Say you can kiss these nuts. Cheap sluts selling ass for like $3. We couldn't even last in the deep, huh? My conversation with labels will make you freeze up. Checks be like the Powerball, nigga, I feel like Freezer. $300,000 an hour, 50 for features. Selling out the stadiums packed, you in the bleachers. Believers, we are the proof for the non-believers. All day I dream about Saks, Adidas.
Hi, my name is...
No, hi, I'm famous and my record hella banging. While my cash stuff in a Cayman. With my brothers like the Wayans, slaughtering beats. Grab the K and shoot away at the arraignment. I'm dangerous.
Create complete compositions with comprehension. Master music theory. Visit busyworksbeats.com/music theory for your free bonuses and free music theory tutorials. Professional mixing secrets finally revealed. Get 3 free videos straight from the new Mixing Academy complete course package at busyworksbeats.com/mac. Want to learn how to make beats like the pros? Join now for free at busyworksbeats.com and learn the secrets of the pros.